Well, eighth grade, today would have been your graduation. And as sad as we are that we had to postpone it to later in June, I wanted to have a little message for each of you, from your teachers from this year and from years past, to just wish you luck in your time going forward from St. Mary's, but also to remember some really great times that you had here, as a Blue Jay. So hopefully you'll enjoy these little video clips, from all kinds of fun teachers, who you've had. And thank you to all the teachers who are willing to send something in. Enjoy the memories, eighth grade.
Do you remember when we looked like this? I do. You were in first grade and you were adorable. You moved up to the big school. You were no longer babies. You learned more about God and started going to Mass twice a week. You read lots of books and became independent readers. You learned your math facts. You pulled cards. You lost baby teeth. You got sore hands from playing on the monkey bars at recess. Susan broke her arm. You made pilgrim hats for Thanksgiving, ornaments for your parents at Christmas, leprechaun masks for St. Patrick's Day, and of course, bunny ears for Easter. You were penguins in the Christmas program. You got to hold baby chicks. And who can forget being visited by Zero the Hero on the 100th day of school? You made new friends and became better friends. You were growing up. Congratulations, eighth grade graduates of 2020.
There's Miss Lauren. Look at her. Happy with her first communion. I remember Lauren as being a delightful child. She was often scared, but her big cousin Megan helped her many, many times.
Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. Homeless for saints and children tell, a heart's meant to forgive.
Look at Drew back there. Here comes Maddie. Doesn't she look holy? What a good girl. Cameron's trying to hop in before his mom, even though I told him not to. And there's Bryn with her brother. Look at that sweet face. Ryan, look at you. Don't you look holy? Isn't it amazing how they have changed over time, but still beautiful? Okay, those people weren't going to get in the pew. Aha, there you go, Luke. Oh, remember the twins? All right. Blake, I know you're back there somewhere. Poor little Blake. I never saw a child who had more tummy aches, God love him. Michaela, look at you. Aren't you pretty?
Let us build a house where love is found in water, wine, and wheat.
Look at Avery. Ah, Will, sneaking in without me getting your picture. God love you. Madison, aren't you cute? Oh, there's Emmy. Isn't she cute? Now I've got my little paper so I can talk about y'all. Susan Boyd, what a sweetheart. Your picture isn't on here, but love you dearly. I will miss you very much. This class, I honestly can say I did not have enough corners in the room to keep those boys from talking. they were nutso talking. Now I'm going to try to talk above this machine. Riley, do you remember on First Communion? Yeah, I don't see you there. I don't know if you got back for this picture or not, but I do remember you being sick and me taking you out, and you had like 101 fever. Lucas, the thing I remember about you the most is that you, and I don't even know if you can remember this, you could see your dad at times, like he was talking to you. I always remembered that. Abram, I love the fact that you never had to follow what everybody else was doing. You could always feel comfortable doing what you did on your own. I'm looking through all the different names here, and there's things that I remember about all of you. But honestly, this is what I remember the most.
Hello and congratulations, class of 2020. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Mrs. Johnson. I used to teach PE and second grade social studies. I retired a few years ago. So I was asked to share some memories of my time at St. Mary's, but I really have some questions for you guys. So eighth graders, do you remember what the name of your second grade salad business was? And where did you donate the profits from the business? Also, do you remember where your flat Stanley went? And let's not forget the President's Physical Fitness Challenge. Do you remember what your time was on the mile run? Did you run the monk run, or did you have to do it at school? So if you ran the monk run, you got the free PE. I hope you guys have some fond memories of your time at St. Mary's, and congratulations and good luck in your future. God bless.
Hi graduates, I was lucky enough to get to teach your class twice, both in kindergarten and again in third grade. And I just remember from both times how unique your class was and what great personalities you have. And really, that's what made your class so special. And I can't think of a more fitting way for you to end your eighth grade year than to do it in your own special way. You gotta make it your own, right? So I know that many of you were my students twice, some just students once, some not at all. But no matter what, I want you to know that you hold a special place in my heart and you hold a special place in our school. So please make sure to come back and visit. And if there's nothing else you took away from my class, remember this, put others first. Do good. I want you to do well in everything, in all the endeavors in your life, but do good. We love you. We'll miss you. Congratulations.
Your first day of fourth grade pics from 2015. Do you remember Tour the States video? Catapults, Vikings, long division steps, divide, multiply. When numbers are stacked, we subtract. Bring down your next number. What about grandparent interviews, state floats, the hokey pokey, or the turkey pokey in November? Just one more picture. From the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 31, verse 8. It is the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you and will never fail you or forsake you. So do not fear or be dismayed. Pray for one another. I wish you all the best. Love and prayers.
Congratulations to each and every one of you, the St. Mary's graduating class of 2020. I'm pleased to be able to speak to you as your former principal and to wish you all the best as you begin your high school journey. This has not been the fun conclusion of your eighth grade year that you anticipated, but circumstances are what they are. God has chosen that your eighth grade year be truly unique as you are. We have always labeled your class as unique, made up of wonderful, fun-loving, special individuals, each with a very unique personality, but somehow unifying into a very special class. Some of you have been at St. Mary's since kindergarten. Some of you joined the class during the last 9 years. But each of you has made your own unique contribution to the class and to the school. Each of you has grown in mind and body and spirit, and we love each one of you. I have memories of you, some truly wonderful memories and some pretty frustrating, like trying to keep your class to a medium roar in the lunchroom when you were the most talkative class I have ever encountered. But you always had enthusiasm and spirit that was truly contagious. I wish you all the best for your next 4 years and beyond. I hope you can take all of the things you learned at St. Mary's and move forward to do great things with your life. I know that you will make us all proud. Thank you for being you and for the memories that we share.
Hello. I have two main memories for our now eighth grade class from fifth grade. The first thing I remember about this class is it was the year of the fidget spinner in fifth grade. I remember collecting fidget spinners from people that had them out during class, and I told them they could come get them on the last day of school, and I ended up with 6 or 7 fidget spinners at the end of school that year. So that was just the ones that went unclaimed at the end of the year. The other thing I remember about this group is how gifted and talented this class is. Very, very academic group, very bright. There's a lot of people that excelled academically. Others had athletic gifts, very athletic class. You can tell from the girls' basketball, the boys' basketball seasons, they had some great athletes. Also, other people had artistic ability like no other class I've had. We had people that were very creative, that could come up with lots of creative writing and inventions and things like that. There were also people that were very musically inclined in this class. So this class has a lot of gifts. I hope you all use them in your future. Good luck in high school.
Hey, eighth grade, it's Mr. Miyagi here. Just want to say congratulations on making it through the school year. This is a particularly weird one for everybody. And congratulations on graduating eighth grade. High school is going to be a whole new world for you. I know it's kind of a cliche, but it's true. So I hope that everything goes well for you. I hope you guys learn a lot and grow closer together and have a whole lot of fun. And remember, play all the dodgeball that you can, because dodgeball is a great metaphor for life. Just because you're hit doesn't mean that you're all the way out. There's still time to make it back into the game. So keep moving, keep playing, keep praying, and grow closer together. God bless you guys, and have a great high school career. See you later.
Hi, eighth grade. I just wanted to let you know how proud I am of each of you. It has been a pleasure to watch you all grow into wonderful young men and women, ready to leave us and move on to high school, hopefully prepared. Please don't be strangers. St. Mary's is always your home. You always have a place here. Stay safe, stay strong. We love you. Bye.
Hello, ninth graders. Congratulations on your graduation. Did you ever think you would make it? Well, yeah, you did. Okay, where do I begin with you guys? Okay, had you in sixth grade science, subbed a little bit in seventh grade, got to see you in seventh grade. Got to visit with you and hang out when I subbed in eighth grade. So, I got to see you grow up. Got to watch you grow up. And that's one of the really cool things about teaching, is if you're lucky enough to hang around long enough, you get to watch this wonderful thing called growing up. I always had, in the past, thought of a symbol that went along with the eighth grade graduating class. And so I kind of did the same thing with you guys. So what kind of symbol? It dawned on me the other day when I got to see my granddaughters. A lot of them, a couple of them had this thing going on. My lovely little thumb. They had different colors on their fingernails. I asked Amelia, how come you got different colors? Because I like them all geeky. I like them all. and they're all different. Okay, good, good. This is my symbol for you guys. Your class, very unique, independent thinkers. You all go to your own drummer, follow your own path. Still part of a class, still together, but very unique, which is great, which kept me on my toes. You guys always made me laugh. You were different, out-of-the-box thinkers, which I appreciate, because I'm kind of this person, like no nail polish or some nail polish, but half of it's bitten off, and you guys are this, which I loved, which I want you to foster, and I want you to stay true to who you are, the best versions of who you are. And I hope that I get to see you around when you're doing the high school thing. That would be great. I hope that you appreciate and are thankful for your families and all those friends and relatives and teachers and anyone and everyone in your life who has encouraged you and helped you to be the best version of who you are. Please make sure that you thank them, because they are part of your journey and they have helped you to get where you are today. Please remember that you're where you're supposed to be, that God has a plan for you. And even though it can be very difficult at times, He's got you. I will miss you. I will think about you often. I will pray for your successes. And I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful life. Love you guys. Take care. Maybe I'll keep this. Love you. Bye.
Hi, 8th grade. I wanted to take a minute and tell you about my favorite memories that I have with you as a class. It was really hard to pick just one, so I didn't. They're all my favorite. Every single one of them. They're my favorite because they were with you. Doesn't matter what we were doing, we did it together. And that's what made it my favorite. However, there were a couple times that I do remember very vividly because of the conversations that came from what we were discussing in class. One of those times was in religion class, and we were talking about sacrifice. Abraham having enough faith in God and trusting God to be able to sacrifice his only son that he had longed for and wished for so many years. And someone asked me if I'd be able to sacrifice, make that sacrifice like Abraham. And at the time, I didn't know that I would be able to make that sacrifice. But after thinking about it, after talking with you about it, it became very obvious that I would be able to make that sacrifice if I decided to put God at the center of my life. That's the key. You can do anything if you decide to put God at the center of your life. So that would be one of the times that I remember fondly of you guys. And the second one, and they kind of go hand in hand, and I know you're going to think this is the craziest thing, but hey, it's me. It's the craziest one. The other one that I have was in August, or maybe it was September, I don't know, but I have the conversation every year. And I don't know that I really realized why I say these things, but in reflecting on what I was going to say to you, it kind of came full circle and made absolutely perfect sense. I don't know if you remember, but in August or September, it's really, really warm. And sometimes, as new seventh graders, you don't realize that there are things that happen in your life that need more care and attention, like personal hygiene. And so we have to talk about deodorant. And I have a phrase, so if you could say it with me now, less
is not more. More is more, and more is better. I know, it's crazy. How does that relate to anything, Mrs. Skaggs? Well, it does. You know, with Abraham and sacrifice, he gave more. He gave it all. Was willing to do that. And his reward was great. It's the same for you. Even in this time of sacrifice, offering up to God, making it so that he is the center, the rewards are going to be great. Even though your story is ending differently, it doesn't make it bad, it just makes it different. And that's what Jesus is all about, different, doing something different. So when you get the opportunity to have an opportunity to sacrifice, make sure you give more, because less is not more, more is more, and more is better. And if you could just take a moment and try to imagine all of the rewards that are waiting for you in heaven because of your sacrifice. Put God at the center, and he will not disappoint you. He will not let you down. So, one more time for good measure. Less is not more. More is more. And more is better. I can't wait till I finally get to see each and every one of you and give you that hug that my arms are longing to give. But in the meantime, I'll sacrifice. I'll offer it up to God and know that he will reward me in time with the best memories of you.
Hello, eighth grade. My favorite memory of you is probably not actually my favorite memory, but more your favorite memory. In sixth grade, I know you remember memorizing the St. Crispin's Day speech from Henry V and making your aluminum foil swords and memorizing it for 2 months and then going out to the grassy field where you got to take your swords and recite the St. Crispin's Day speech and then run across the field screaming as though you were going into battle. And I thought it would be a great idea to run at you with my sword as well and surprise you. And it all seemed like a very, very wonderful idea until I fell flat on my face with 30 adolescents hurtling toward me, unable to stop. And all I can say is thank you. Thank you for not stepping on my face. God bless you. Good luck next year. Stick together and help each other. I'll be praying for you. Have a good summer. Bye.
I just wanted to wish each and every one of you congratulations on a job well done. It's been a pleasure being your teacher this year. I know that God has great things in store for each and every one of you, and I can't wait to see God's plan played out in your life. I have many, many fond memories of you guys, from our dance parties to our dodgeball games to even just having our meaningful discussions in class. I will miss you, and I can't wait to see you guys at graduation.
Hello, guys. We were asked to do a short video of our favorite memory of your class, and I'm going to read mine because it's so much easier for all of us. I have known most of you since kindergarten, with the new students added along the way. We have had our rough times as well, as all classes do, but the good times far outweigh the rough. My favorite memory in particular is every year at Christmas time. You always do more than is asked of you by making cards for people in nursing homes. You didn't know these people, but you did your very best. You have done your very best on every group project presented to you throughout your years here at St. Mary's. What you don't know is that my father received one of the cards you made. His smile was a wonderful thing to see. He asked me if the card was from one of my kids, and I was happy to say, yes, Dad, it was. Hang on, it'll be okay. For this memory, I say thank you. You have good hearts and a willingness to go above and beyond what is asked of you. Take that with you as you start your new adventure. I will keep you in my prayers, and you'll always be in my heart.
Hello, St. Mary Cathedral graduating class of 2020. Father Kelly here. Just wanted to offer a quick note of congratulations to each and every one of you, and also to encourage you as you move on to this next chapter of life to take with you all the many good things that you have learned in your time at St. Mary's, and of course to always strive to be the saint that God calls you to be. Once again, congratulations, and may God bless each and every one of you.
Hey, 8th grade, what's going on? Mr. Winkler here. Just wanted to tell you guys congratulations on your graduation. You are officially in the big leagues now with high school, so there's no more goofing around, all right? You hear me? I was asked to give my favorite moment of our time together, our short time together. I'm going to go with the most recent moment we had. I don't know if you guys remember this, but we were over there along the bleachers, and we used a yoga ball, and we couldn't let the yoga ball hit the ground. We had to use our feet to keep it up from one side to the other. And I remember people thinking, like, oh, there's no way we'd be able to do this, and we bet a class key on it. And you guys were the first and only class to make it down and back and down. No other class is able to do that. And it showed me, and I hope it showed you guys, that there's such a bond between all of you guys. Every single person, I feel like you're all close. It doesn't matter who you are, you're willing to go up and talk to anybody and be friends with everyone in your class, and that's something special. Keep that going while you get into high school, and I'm going to miss you guys. Congratulations on everything, and the hard work doesn't stop. Keep on grinding. Mr. Winkler, see you guys later.
Hey, 8th grade, this is Mrs. Meyer coming to you from the Hogwarts restricted section in the library. I wanted to say congratulations to all of you for your hard work, and especially in the strange situations we've had this year. And I want to tell you I'm sorry it has to be in this kind of venue instead of in person. But I wanted to remind you of some of the characters you met here in the library and how they overcame some difficult situations. To begin with, Harry Potter, of course, overcame bullying and a very difficult home life to find some very loving and kind friends and mentors that helped him become successful and become happy. And he learned from his difficult situations and learned to work hard. I also want you to remember some advice you got from Greg Heffley in Diary of a Wimpy Kid, and then do just the opposite. And some of you will remember Christina Caterina and the box. I read you this in kindergarten, and you learned how Christina took an ordinary paper box and created a lot of fun things out of it. And I hope you can create a lot of fun things and a lot of happiness in your life. Congratulations again, 8th grade. This is Mrs. Meyer.
Hey, 8th grade, Mr. Hyman here. Congratulations on making it to the end of 8th grade at St. Mary's. It's time for your graduation, and it's going to be a different one. But as we look back over the years, there's definitely been some good memories with you. And a lot of my memories circle around our time spent together doing Christmas programs. As I look over my list here, you've been elves, penguins, candy canes, cats and dogs, reindeer, Santas, Mrs. Claus. You've been the Toonies of Toonville. And then, of course, all the characters that presented our out-of-box Christmas this past year. Who could forget Susan as a little singing penguin in first grade, all the way to being Mrs. Strickert in eighth grade, and Mrs. Claus in fifth grade, by the way, and Abram also as Santa in fifth grade, and Will as Elphys. I don't think any of us will forget that. It's been a good run for 9 years, and I'm proud to be your music teacher, and I hope you have a great time in high school. Congratulations and good luck.
Well, 8th grade, you've made it. Tonight, like I said at the beginning, would have been graduation, and I can't wait to celebrate with you in June and get to talk to you then. But you're a great group of kids. And I know some of you, we had some more intimate conversations, a little more one-on-one than others, but I got a great privilege of spending 3 years with you. When you started in sixth grade, you were the biggest class in the school, and there were 32 of you, and you were all rather crazy, but it was fun. And in seventh grade, you guys were good sports and helped out in a lot of ways, especially with such a small eighth grade class last year. And then this year I got to spend some time with you every day or every week in confirmation prep. And some of you I got to experience the Luke 18 retreat with. And you all just continued to amaze me. All very different personalities, but all of you have such beautiful gifts and you really live them out. I really got to enjoy helping you pick confirmation saints and getting to see you present on those saints who have made an impact in your lives. And I really encourage you to turn to them, especially during all of this, as your patrons and help you through the uncertainty, the unknown. And just know that you all have been really good to me and I've really enjoyed my time with you. One thing I thought was always funny that your class did, you were always rather loud in the cafeteria. You'd kind of like stumble in and just be loud and crazy. And I always kind of knew who was going to buy what at the a la carte. I wish I could buy you all donuts or a pastry for Neil or something like that. And Drew eating way too many Rice Krispie treats. But you all made me laugh. And some of you were ridiculous and piling food up on your trays you didn't want to eat. I forgot what you called it, but it was very funny. And some of you always like to ask how I was doing, how my kids were doing. You were always up for letting me show you a picture or two or tell you a story. And you may have just half-heartedly laughed, but I appreciated it. So I am so proud of how you've handled the last few months. And I look forward to seeing what God does in your life. And I wish you the best. And I want to end this by reminding you that you went to St. Mary's. So continue to go to St. Mary. Go to Our Lady, Jesus' mother, with all your petitions, all your concerns, all your worries. And the prayer on the prayer card I like to give the graduates is the Memorare. And it's always such a beautiful means of just offering things to her and entrusting that petition, that care, that worry to her. And so I would like us to end with that. And I'm going to have you just spend some time looking at the Lord on the cross there as we pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother, the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy, hear and answer me. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good luck, graduates, and congratulations.